Thank you to the people of Cleveland for hosting our great convention. Thank you very much. This is such a great honor and to be back. We had an awfully good time the last time, you remember, right? A thing called the Republican National Convention, and it was great. Special. And I want to thank Patrick Park and Ray Park. They own this building. They do such a great job. It's incredible, and it's an honor. They kept moving the walls out. They just said, could we make it bigger, bigger, bigger? But we have some great crowds, and I just want to thank everybody. Special. Ohio is a special place, and Cleveland is a special place and always will be to me. And I want to thank our future Vice President Mike Pence and Karen. What a job they've done. It's a great team. It's really a team. But they have been spectacular, and it's an honor to be working with them. And I have to tell you, I love those pink, let me see that, Women for Trump. Those are my favorite. Those are my favorite. Oh, we're going to do so well with the women. It's crazy. Wait till those numbers come out in November, on November 8th. Wait till those numbers come out. In 17 days, we are going to win the great state of Ohio, and we are going to win the White House. Early voting is underway, so make sure you get that ballot out. Otherwise, this whole movement, honestly, we will have pretty much wasted a lot of time and energy. Now, me, it would have been time, energy, and I guess by the time I'm finished, over $100 million. That's a lot of money. But we have something that's so special that I don't think there's a chance they can take it away from us. We're going to win. We're going to win November 8th. And together we're going to deliver real change that once again puts America first. As an example, this used to be a great plant. Thousands and thousands of people worked here, and they left. So many people are leaving. So many people are closing their businesses and moving to Mexico and other countries. Not going to happen anymore. We're going to tell you why, but not going to happen anymore. Earlier today, I outlined my contract with the American voter, a detailed list of solutions to make your life richer and better. One of the issues I addressed at length is the issue of government corruption. I talked about the inside dealing, the powerful protecting the powerful, and about special interests and donors who've rigged the system. The system is rigged. You know it. I know it. The politicians know it. The media people know it. They all know it. I've talked about the corrupt career lifetime politicians like Hillary Clinton selling her office for personal enrichment, and you've seen how that's going. I've got news for all of the people taking advantage of our rigged system. In 17 days, everything is going to change. In 17 days, we are going to drain the swamp of corruption in Washington, D.C. We are going to renegotiate our terrible trade deals, end illegal immigration, stop the massive inflow of refugees coming from the Middle East, reduce surging crime, cut taxes and regulations, unleash American energy, including shale, oil, natural gas, and beautiful, clean coal. We're going to put those miners back to work. We will rebuild our military and take care of our great veterans. And that means new aircraft for Wright-Patterson Air Force Base right here in Ohio. We will also repeal and replace the total disaster known as Obamacare. Health insurance premiums are going through the roof, led by Obamacare, and companies are being driven out of business. They're leaving our country over the cost of health care. It is a total disaster. Many companies are being forced to flee. Fire everybody, flee, go to another country. We're going to stop it day one. And Hillary Clinton wants to double down and make Obamacare bigger and even worse. Just this month, the Democratic governor of Minnesota admitted the reality is the Affordable Care Act, he said, is no longer affordable. He said that. And you probably saw last week, Bill Clinton called Obamacare the craziest thing in the world. He said that small businesses and middle-class Americans are getting killed. He then went home, and he got killed. He tried taking it back the next day. He did not have the same enthusiasm. He was he had a rough evening. That was a tough evening. But look, whether you are Hillary Clinton or anybody else, Obamacare is a disaster. Premiums are going up 60, 70, 80, 90%. Next year, it's going to be worse. You know, at a certain point, and it's lousy health care. It's terrible. The deductibles are so high, I mean, you don't want to use it anyway. But if you need it, you'll never get to use it because the deductibles have gotten so high. So it's a horror show. We're going to repeal it and replace it. And this is our chance to get rid of this law, but we're going to approve and get something that is so much less expensive and so good, a great health care system, a system that you deserve. That's what we're going to be doing. And that's one of many things. Folks, we have so many things. We could stand here for 2 days and just talk. But we're going to go over a lot of them. Among our reforms, is he one of the people paid for by the Democrats and the Clinton campaign? Are you paid? Get out of here. Get out. Out. Get out. Did you read that the other day? They're paid $1,500. They're violent. They want to have violence. And everybody blamed it on me, and now they're saying, guess what? Trump was actually innocent. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Among our reforms will be to cut the red tape at the FDA and speed the approval of life-saving drugs. Your jobs will come back under a Trump administration. Your incomes will go up under a Trump administration. Your taxes will go way down under a Trump administration, and she's going to raise your taxes. Your companies won't be leaving Ohio under a Trump administration. They won't be going, believe me, to another country where they're offered a little bit better deal. You'll be proud of your leaders once again. Now, WikiLeaks shows us that John Podesta said Hillary Clinton has bad instincts. Bernie Sanders said she has bad judgment. What are we doing, folks? These people work with her. What are we doing? One of her close allies said she doesn't seem to know what planet we're all living in. This is her allies saying this. The emails also show her staff saying she has no core. She has no core. That's because she just does whatever her donors and special interests want her to do. We're not too happy with her, I will tell you. Look, it's a rigged system. That's how she got to run. It's a rigged system. The whole entire purpose of her campaign is to keep our system rigged and to stop change from happening at any cost. And we need change. We are about change. She is about keeping it the way it is. And we don't want to have four more years of Obama. That we can tell you. Just take a look at her record. She's been there, think of this. She's been there for 30 years and hasn't fixed anything. She's unleashed death, destruction, and failure in every country she touched in the Middle East. Iraq, Libya, Syria, Iran. Hillary's catastrophic failures unleashed ISIS, right? The great vacuum that she and Obama created, which is now on a campaign of genocide against Christians in the Middle East and all over the world. They're in 32 countries. When they started, during her tenure as Secretary of State, when they started as a little group. Remember the JV? Obama called them the JV. They're now in 32 countries, and now I watch as Hillary Clinton says, I'm going to stop ISIS. Why didn't she stop it in the first place? Why did she let it start? When will she take responsibility for all of the death and suffering and bloodshed she caused all around the world? Look at what she's done. When will she apologize for all of the people her decisions have gotten killed? At home, she failed on the economy, and she failed in upstate New York. She said in the Senate she's going to bring jobs, elect me. Guess what? The place emptied out. Companies like Carrier are firing their workers and moving to Mexico. Ford is moving all of its small car production to Mexico. Who knows better than Cleveland what's going on? Who knows? Look at this place. Who knows better than Cleveland? And right next door, you're losing another big monster, and they're moving to Mexico. I hope you know that, but they're moving to Mexico. We're going to stop it, folks. We're going to stop it dead in its tracks. When I'm president, if companies want to fire their workers and leave for Mexico or some other place, then we will charge them a 35% tax when they want to ship their products back into the United States. And when they hear that, they're not moving. Now, they may move to another state. That's different, right? You got to fight for your own, right? But they're not moving to these other countries and firing all of their people. You have to see the numbers. We've lost 77,000 factories. 77,000. Hillary Clinton has raised countless millions of dollars from big donors who want to ship our jobs to these other countries. The system is rigged, and the best evidence of that is that Hillary Clinton is even allowed to run for the office of president in the first place. She lied to Congress under oath She lied to the FBI, and she made 13 phones disappear, many of them by whacking them with a hammer. How many people have made your phones disappear and whacked them out with a hammer? Anybody here? Oh, no. Here's a guy right up here. Sir, what business are you in? I don't want to know. She bleached and deleted 33,000 emails and then two crucial boxes of email evidence is now mysteriously missing. 2 weeks ago. Her actions with her illegal server have put every single American family at risk. She is the most corrupt person ever to seek the presidency of the United States. Her career embodies what the American people loathe about corrupt, self-serving establishment that has stripped this country of its jobs, its wealth, and its opportunity, and we're going to turn it around, and we're really going to turn it around. That's not just words. Her campaign even mocks Catholics and evangelicals. Who is Catholic in this room? Whoa. I know you're not voting for her. Who is evangelical in this room? Whoa! She's in trouble. I know you're not voting for her. And she smears police officers as essentially racist, and she smears all of you as deplorable and irredeemable. She eagerly takes millions of dollars from countries that murder and oppress women, gays, and people of different faith, and refuses to give all of that money back. In fact, I brought that up in the debate. By the way, how badly did we beat her in the debate? That wasn't a close one. We will defend religious liberty, and we will defend the rights of all people. Then, there is the issue that everybody says, oh, it doesn't take place. Are these people playing games with us? Right? Oh, it doesn't take place. These are the people that negotiate our trade deals. These are the people that don't know what's going on in real life. Or these are the people that are just playing games with you. There is the issue of voter fraud. Isn't it amazing the way they say there's no voter fraud? Folks, it's a rigged system. And it's a rigged election, believe me. According to the highly respected Pew, there are 24 million voter registrations in the United States that are either invalid or significantly inaccurate. Lot, right? 24 million, lot. There are 1.8 million dead people that are registered right now to vote. And folks, some of them vote. I wonder why. I wonder how that happened. They woke up from the dead and they went and voted. There are 2.8 million people that are registered in more than one state. So we'll vote here. Let's ride down the road. Let's vote next one. Maybe they'll vote for Trump. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't be saying this. I may be hurting myself. You're right. You're right. Maybe they're going to vote for Trump. All right. Let's forget that. It's okay for them to do it. 14% of non-citizens are registered to vote. The system is also rigged by the media. WikiLeaks shows the media colluding and conspiring directly with the Clinton campaign. Emails even show the Clintons boasting gleefully about very friendly and malleable reporters who shower the Clintons with praise. I know the people they're talking about. To us, they're very dishonest. For instance, those cameras, they'll never show these crowds. They'll never show these crowds. It's all rigged, but on November 8th, we're going to show them and we're going to beat the system. And we will end the corruption in Washington. We will make America great again. You watch. We're going to also end economic stagnation in our country. At the center of my jobs plan, we'll be fixing our terrible, terrible, terrible trade deals. We have nearly an $800 billion annual trade deficit with the world. In other words, we deal with the world, we have a deficit of $800 billion. You know, in the audience, I have a lot of friends. They're from this area. They're all great business people. I could put any one of them in charge, and we could do well. But the people we have negotiating the biggest deals in the world are political hacks, like the Iran deal. How bad was the Iran deal? How bad was that? And how about when we gave them $400 million in cash? Forget the $150 billion. We gave them $400 million in cash, but we were wrong. It was actually $1.7 billion in cash. You know what? That'd fill up the whole side of this room. Also, remember, this is, and you don't hear that from these characters, this is the worst so-called recovery that we've had in this country since the Great Depression. Ohio, and just look at this building, but look at all the other buildings around it. Ohio has lost 1 in 3 of its manufacturing jobs since NAFTA, a deal signed by Bill Clinton and supported by crooked Hillary Clinton. Hillary visits states like Ohio, Pennsylvania, and Michigan, talks about jobs, but she's the one who killed the jobs in the first place. Why didn't she do something about it? You probably saw in the debate. She'd say, well, I want to do this, I want to do that, I want to do this. I said, why didn't you do it? You've been there for 30 years. Why didn't you do it? It's just talk. It's political talk. It's all talk, no action. It's like a bank robber visiting the scene of a crime. We've lost 70,000 factories since China's entry into the World Trade Organization. You know, when I saw the 70,000 number, honestly, I thought it was a typo. I said 70,000. Think of what 70,000 is. You know, here we're talking 4 in this area. 70,000 throughout our country. I thought it was a typo. It's not a typo. We've lost 70,000 factories. Another Bill and Hillary-backed disaster. We're living through the greatest jobs theft in the history of the world. There's no other country that has ever been raided like our country has been raided of its jobs and its money and its wealth. We owe $20 trillion. It doubled. Think of it. It doubled in just 8 years. It's really a little less. It doubled. Think of it. A Trump administration is going to renegotiate NAFTA, stand up to foreign cheating, and stop the jobs from leaving our country. And we are going to stop currency manipulation, the number one game they play. They're grandmasters. But we're going to stop currency manipulation because that's cheating. And our companies cannot compete with that. We are going to start making things again in America. As part of our plan to bring back our jobs, we're going to lower our business tax from 35%, which is the highest anywhere in the world, to 15%, which is among the lowest. We are also going to rebuild our inner cities. And you know about that. African Americans and Hispanics living in the inner cities are suffering very badly and very unfairly. The violence is unbearable and unbelievable. You walk to the store with your child and you get shot. There is no education, there are no jobs, and there is no safety. Nearly 3,500 people have been shot in the city of Chicago since the beginning of the year. Can you believe that? 3,500 people. That's worse than these war zones you're seeing. Homicides are up nearly 50% in Washington, D.C., and more than 60% in Baltimore. And it's getting worse. So to the African American community and to the Hispanic community and voters, I say, what do you have to lose? Vote for Donald Trump. I will fix it. I will fix it. True. True. So true. We will be a rich nation again. A woman came up to me recently. She said, Mr. Trump, I love listening to you speak, but I hate it when you say, we will be rich again as a nation. I say, I'm sorry, but if we're not going to be rich again, we're going to lose all of those things because I'm going to save your Social Security with Hillary. She's going to cut it to pieces. And we're leaving it the way it is because that was the contract you made. But Hillary is going to cut it to pieces. So many things. So I said to her, look, I know it doesn't sound politically correct or nice, but we are going to be a rich nation again. We have to be. To do what we want to do, because we have to build up our military, we have to do so many things. But to be a rich nation, we must also be a safe nation. National security begins at the border. Speaking in secret to a foreign bank, Hillary Clinton said her dream is for totally open trade, there go your jobs, and open borders, there goes your country. There goes your country. WikiLeaks, WikiLeaks. We will build the wall. And who is going to pay for the wall? Who? No, we're going to build the wall. Mexico is going to pay for the wall. You know, Mexico, you talk about trade deficits. Mexico is making a fortune off the United States. And they're great people. They're great people. And they have leadership that's smarter, more cunning, sharper than our leaders. But we have a massive trade deficit with Mexico. And I'm not talking about the drugs that are pouring in and poisoning our youth in Ohio and New Hampshire and Pennsylvania and Virginia and every place else. We're going to build a wall. We're going to stop the poison from pouring in. We're going to do things that will make you so proud. We're going to be proud of our country again. Anyone who supports open borders can never be and should never be allowed to be the president of the United States, and she supports open borders. With that radical pledge, Hillary Clinton betrayed every single citizen of the United States, as she's been doing for many years, and as she certainly did with her emails and her servers and all of the illegal things. And she's also opened the door to unlimited drugs pouring into your community, which Ohio does not want. You have a big problem with it. You have a big problem with it. You know, a four-star general, General Cartwright, highly respected. Four-star. We're talking top of the line. Highly respected man. 2 days ago was severely criticized and will probably have to serve almost 5 years in prison for lying to the FBI. And he said he did it for national security reasons, and I understand that. But he lied one time to the FBI. Hillary Clinton lied so many times, nobody can count that high. So sad. So sad. And you look at General Petraeus. General Petraeus was severely sanctioned. General Petraeus, his life was essentially destroyed for doing a tiny fraction of what Hillary Clinton did. A tiny fraction. Look at General Cartwright. Look at General Petraeus. And these are great men. And look what happened to them. Their lives are destroyed. And they did nothing, nothing compared to what Hillary Clinton did. And look at all of the other people over the years that have suffered grave consequences. And they did nothing compared to what she's done. Hillary's plan includes an open border with the Middle East, meaning generations of radicalism and terrorism spreading and growing within your communities and near your families. And most people don't even know where they're going, including governors and senators. Nobody knows. This is going to be the great Trojan horse. And you have to say, I've been very good at predicting things. So let me state this as clearly as I can. If I'm elected president, I'm going to keep radical Islamic terrorists the hell out of our country. We will also stop the crisis of illegal immigration. A Trump administration will secure and defend our borders. And I said before, we'll build the wall, but we'll do much more than build the wall. We're going to use a lot of this. We're going to be tough. We're going to be vigilant. We're going to be smart. We have the first ever endorsement from our ICE and Border Patrol officers, 16,500. These are great Americans, and they want to do their job right. And the amazing thing is, their job is so much easier if Hillary got in, because all they have to do is stand there and let the people walk right in front of them. With me, they have to work, and that's what they want to do, because they know what's happening better than any consultants we could hire and pay millions of dollars. They tell you in 2 minutes what's happening. And I said to them, how important is the wall? And they said, Mr. Trump, it's very, very important, especially for the stoppage of drug flow coming into our country. It's very, very important. As Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton allowed thousands of criminal aliens to be released because their home countries would not take them back. These are gang members, these are killers, these are drug dealers. We'd bring them back to their home country, and their country said, very intelligently, we don't want them, take them out of here. We won't accept them. I promise you, as president, there won't be one such instance. Those people will be gladly accepted by their home country. It was just reported that a man deported from our country 10 times in 6 years has been charged with raping a 12-year-old girl. In August, Texas police arrested a serial, illegal immigrant rapist who had been deported 5 times. His victims included one 68-year-old woman with a cane who took his offer to drive him home. He left her on the side of a dirt road in horrible, horrible condition. The 64-year-old Air Force veteran, Marilyn Ferris, an unbelievable woman, was raped and beaten to death with a hammer by a repeat offending criminal illegal immigrant who should have been deported many times by the Obama administration, but never, ever was, and people still don't understand it. Under a Trump administration, this crime wave ends, and it ends very, very quickly. With a victory in November, everything will change. In closing, here are some of the amazing things we're going to do for our country starting in 2017. We are going to stop the drugs and illegal immigration from pouring into our country. We are going to give, authorize, and get approved the biggest tax cut since Ronald Reagan, and even bigger. And included in that is major simplification, major, major simplification. The only one that won't be happy is H&R Block. They will not be happy. We are going to eliminate every unnecessary job-killing regulation, which are killing our businesses. That's what they're really killing. We will defend religious liberty in our country and elsewhere. We will provide school choice to every disadvantaged child in America. And we are going to end, once and for all, Common Core and bring our education local. We will support the great men and women of law enforcement. We are going to save our Second Amendment, which is under siege. And we will appoint justices to the United States Supreme Court who will uphold and defend the Constitution of the United States. You have 17 days to make this all happen. Your future is really in your hands. I didn't have to do this. This is hard, hard work. Many people in this room are making less money now than they made 18 years ago, an amazing statistic. And then you had a great job. Today you're working two and three jobs. But many people, think of it, in this room are older, making less money, and working much harder. Now, here's the good news. I'm older and working much harder also. So I don't feel so bad. I don't feel guilty. I don't feel guilty. But I didn't have to do this. I built a great company, a great, great company, some of the greatest assets in the world, some of the greatest real estate assets in the world. You know, if I win, I may never get to see them again. It's true. But I built some of the great, great real estate assets in the world. And honestly, it's so unimportant compared to what we're talking about, which is saving the United States of America. So I didn't have to do it. And I've been on the other side. I talk about the other side. I know the other side. Who knows the other side better than me? And I said, the country's in very, very serious trouble, and we're going to do it. So I became the ultimate insider. In one day, when I said, on June 16th, coming down the escalator with Melania, in one day, I went from the ultimate insider to, man, have I become the ultimate outsider, right? So we have created a movement the likes of which nobody has ever seen before in this country. Thank you. You're my hero, let me tell you. Like that guy. I don't know who he is, but I like, who did that? Who said that? I like you. Look at the arm, strong guy. Tough guy. You have to go out. You have to get everyone you know, get them to vote. I often say, if you're really sick, you go to the doctor. He gives you the worst message he can give you. You know what that message is. You've got 2 months. Not going to make it. It's really bad and really serious. That doesn't matter. On November 8th, you get up and you get out to vote, right? No. No. But nobody in this room is ever going to get sick. November 8th. Our campaign is powered by our love for this country and our love for one another. Is there ever anywhere a better place to be than a Trump rally? Look at it. No better place and no safer place. Even when they hired people for $1,500 to go and beat up our people, you know what they found? You know what they found? And by the way, they hurt a lot of police. You saw that. You saw the blood pouring down. Those people should be criminally prosecuted. Okay? And you know what? The people that hired them, including the person that visited the White House 344 times, should be criminally prosecuted. By the way, if that were us, forget it. Do you really believe anything's going to happen to those people? Isn't it sad? Our country has never been in a position like this. It's never, ever been our justice system. It's never been when somebody can lie and lie and lie. Other people far greater than her, lives are being destroyed. But they can lie and lie and everything goes like nothing. But other people are destroyed. I'm going to fight for every citizen of every background from every stretch of this nation. I'm going to fight for every child living in poverty. I'm going to fight for every mom and every dad who lost her or his child to illegal immigration and drugs and gang violence, which is all over this country. I'm going to fight for every community whose jobs and factories have been ripped out of your states like Ohio and shipped to other countries like Mexico and many, many more. I'm going to fight for every person in this country who believes government should serve the people, not the donors and not the special interests. I'm going to fight to bring us all together as Americans. We're a divided country. We will not be a divided country for long. Imagine what our country could accomplish if we started working together as one people under one God, saluting one American flag. In 10 years, in 20 years, in 30 years, and maybe for some, in 40 and 50 years, you're going to look back at this rally for the rest of your life. You're going to remember this day. This is a movement like no one in this country has ever seen before. We have a big crowd today, but we have big crowds everywhere. Many of the pundits have said it's the single greatest political phenomenon they've ever seen in their lifetime. Bill O'Reilly said it. We're going to look back at this election and say this is by far the most important vote you've ever cast for anyone at any time, November 8th. We're 17 days away from achieving the change we've been waiting for our entire lives. It's going to happen. You're going to be so proud of your country again. And hopefully, you're going to be so proud of your president. Because we're going to start winning again. We're going to start winning again. And we're going to make America wealthy again. And we're